You are watching Bloodstock TV, and I am sitting here with the guys from Comedy Christ. Hello, or should I say good morning or good afternoon? Yeah, how are you doing?
Good morning in touring life.
Yeah, well, good morning in touring life. welcome back to Bloodstock. It's absolutely amazing to have you guys back. I was trying to remember the last time you were here, and
2018.
Yeah, I was like, was that six years ago?
Yeah.
That was 6 years, and when I think about that, it's like,
it's crazy,
doesn't even,
right?
Doesn't even seem real.
No.
Your last performance was absolutely a highlight for me. It was amazing to see something really eclectic and different go up on that stage, between sandwiched in between some absolutely brutal music, metal music. And it's always just great to see how accepting audiences are, which leads me to asking you this, which is, you are so multifaceted in where you guys can play. I mean, there's EDM festivals, industrial, metal, whatever it is. And like, does that make the touring life just a little bit more exciting, that you're just coming into all of these different atmospheres and environments all the time, rather than like, we play black metal and this is where
we play? I mean, we're all metal people. Like, we're all from the metal scene originally, and punk and hardcore and stuff. And you know, 90s, like, you were, when we were touring in 90s with all the bands, it was always like, you kind of always get it. Every night it would be the same. It wouldn't even be the same lineups, but it felt like it was the same lineup, you know what I mean? And day after day after day. And it made me, that's what made me started bringing in electronics and stuff like that, and doing different things, because I just needed that variety, you know. Mm-hmm. Just needed something different. And also because we listen to everything, as most of the people at the festivals do, and most of the bands really do. Mm. They really listen to everything, you know. Mm. So it was just taking in all these inspirations from all other music styles that you listen to, and try to mash it all in, and try to be able to play all the different festivals
finding a balance there with all that. Okay, let's talk about the new album, which is still box fresh almost. Now, when that sort of landed and I clicked it open to look at it, 23 tracks on the album, so to speak, and it's clocking in over 1.5 hours. Now, did you set out to write so many tracks, or was it something that just kind of happened as you were going along?
I mean,
more tracks than that.
Yeah, it was a lot more. It was a lot more.
Did you write like 70 tracks and then condense them down?
More than that, probably too. But it was the main album, which was, you know, it's the 13s, which I tried to stick to.
The number 13 tracks.
And this, it's not even my lucky number. I just got stuck on a little OCD.
Okay.
It's just, but that's what I focus on, and try to, not to try to get it up to 13, but it's like getting down to 13.
Yeah.
And kind of sort out and filter out and make sure that there's no real, that there's no fillers or anything, you know. And then the other tracks were like, really, it was record label was it's like, hey, what about if you do one of those, you know, experimental ambient bonus albums that you've done before? And and it was like, well, okay, it's a cool idea, like, we see if we can't do
sure,
it again.
Yeah.
And Elliot and I, we just kind of set the task, and we kind of made a fake movie, and we laid down the titles first, so we kind of had a concept of a movie. Like, there was like, okay, down the hallway and into the morgue, and you know, like, tried to it. So we did that first, and then we kind of soundtracked a fake movie. That's really what we did. But that's
such an interesting way of going about it. Like, it's a total full circle in terms of vision, and really. Yeah. Getting the best kind of atmosphere that you can get, I suppose, with the music.
So that's what we did with that bonus album, and
great. Combi Christ vision started back in 2003. Am I correct?
Yeah.
So 20 mm-hmm. years, you've passed the 20-year milestone. Do you feel when you started out with the idea 2003? Do you feel that it's what you had envisioned you're scratching that itch that you're finally at a place where you have, because it takes time to evolve and find, oh, this works, this doesn't work. Mm-hmm. Like, was this the vision from the start of where you are now? Or do you still feel that there's more kind of horizon and expansion for the Comedy Christ sound?
It's a never ending progress, because the whole idea of the first album, which is basically just an electronic noise album, it's mostly instrumental, the first album. I was been touring with hardcore bands and forever at this point, and I just wanted to do something different. It was just for me, you know. It wasn't really, I didn't have any vision on even doing it live when I started. It was kind of like I used to call it the studio desktop cleanup. And it was like the first album was kind of like all the stuff that I've done in between writing, like.
So the erratic kind of madness in between when you've been off the road, and almost like a stress reliever, just like, yeah. Cool.
And it was like, what am I doing with this? Let's throw a name on it and release it, kind of thing, just so it's out of the studio.
So you had no fucking idea that this would come to what it is now?
Not even on the second album. Wow. Or the third album or fourth album. It's always been a natural progress.
Yeah.
I think we'd never really know what's going on from one tour or record to the next. It's been a ride.
It's really like we just kind of go, I go back from tour and I was like, you know what I would like more of? You know, this is what I want to do. Mm. Like, and you go back and that's what's been the main theme of Comedy Christ all along, was that I did something different on every album.
Yeah.
But of course, there's a red line, but if you take the first album and the latest album, there doesn't seem to be a red line.
But that's the evolution. And even the confidence in what you're doing and
learning. Yeah, it goes from the lizard to the human, you know? It's like every album in between is the evolution of the monkey to man.
That's a great title, actually, from the lizard to the human. Fucking great title.
I mean, the way we started working on the new record was Andy basically going like, what if ninjas were Vikings in the future at a techno club playing metal, Mike?
It was more or less exactly what we were saying on the last album. I was just like, because we're big, you know, we're still metalheads. So it's like, I'm thinking like, okay, so what if it was black metal, but it's not black metal and it's in Tokyo? And it's like, not now, but it's in the future.
but it's really interesting that like you actually have to visualize all of this, and then you then use that as a point of reference to write towards.
Yeah.
Like, it's a really cool way of doing it, but it is hilarious, I suppose, to just get the most further bipolar opposite things and say, what can we do with like Vikings and futuristic religion robots or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
You know, but yeah, that's fucking awesome. One of the things that I had come across when I was just delving into you guys is the way you write. And you write, you've confessed as well that you write very slow when it comes to lyrics. You don't rush the process, you know? Do you start with the concept? I know you kind of mentioned there that you try to visualize a scenario, and it was really interesting you saying that you almost created a movie, but have you ever, like, was that the way you've always written music, that you know, or did you ever kind of just sit down pen and paper and kind of just come up with an idea and just bash out the lyrics rather than kind of conceptualize a whole situation?
I mean, sometimes the process between lyrics and the music is completely separate too. So sometimes you have this concept of an idea of the music by itself, and then you kind of go through all the stuff you've been writing and say, what did I already write that fits this song?
Sure.
You know, that happens. Or it can be only the music, and then I start writing what fits to this, like, and it rhythmically or whatever, and then you kind of start analyzing like, where do I want to go here with the lyrics, or the complete opposite. I have just the lyrics, and I was like, what kind of music do I want for these lyrics? And it's different from every song, really.
Mm-hmm.
And most of the lyrics are are like, obviously in the past it was a lot of just, you know, I just had fun with it. It was like, it was really nothing important. It was, I just want something kind of fun or brutal or, you know, like,
yeah.
It's like, look at a lot of the older death metal bands and so on. I mean, like, let's face it, it's not very serious. Mm. You know, it's a lot of just like, this sounds brutal.
Escapism, you know? With brutality.
Yeah, for sure. And it's like, because in the end, the vocal is just another instrument. So it doesn't have to mean anything. Mm. The vocal is an instrument.
Yeah.
So it doesn't, like, people go like, you can't even understand what you're singing. And I was like,
you don't need to.
It's an instrument. It's like, do you understand what a guitar is saying?
Try and translate obituary in the 80s. Yeah. Like, nobody knew what was, like, saying. Yeah.
So, but then over the years, I more and more put my heart into it, because you realize you have a voice, and people start taking things seriously, you know. Mm-hmm. So you have a voice, so you're trying to shape that in a way where it means something, you know, for yourself. Like, you suddenly realize that you are, people take what I'm saying seriously. So now I need to,
you're like, oh fuck,
I need to really think about what I'm saying here. But it's just social documentary. That's really what it is.
Okay, cool. So what is, obviously, you're playing Bloodstock here this weekend. Coming into the end of the year, into next year, what are future plans for Combi Christ?
Next step, man. You know, step up or go home, you know?
Yeah.
You gotta take that next step or quit. That's so it.
Just more touring, more everything, yeah.
And bigger production, more music, and you gotta, it's like there's no room for not doing anything, right, really.
Yeah. You just gotta keep doing it, moving forward. Excellent. Well, we are out of time. We have a very hectic schedule here today, but listen, thank you so much for coming over.
Oh, thank you for having us.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this performance.
It's gonna be great.
Right. So listen, Combi Christ on Bloodstock TV. Please go and check out everything the guys have done, and keep an eye on them. There's exciting things coming up in the future going forward, and prepare to just get your head blown off when you see them live, because it's fucking amazing.
It is.
Combi Christ, thank you so much. Awesome.